Hello, in this video you will learn how we can compute the true false positive rate. So we will try to understand how we can compute the true false positive value for the face detector that we recently created. And here we have two classes. First is face detected. This is positive case. Second is face not detected. That is negative case. This is the face detector that we recently created. This is the input image. And this is the image after pre-processing. And here we have the binary features extracted from the distal image, its histogram and its feature values. And here this is the face detected using BJ, face detected using MBLVP, and here you can see image is rotated as 180 degree and face is detected. Here you can see the image movement. Here this is the original image, you can see the eyes and you can see the image after rotation, and this is the PSNR value. So now we will understand how we can compute the true false positive values. So we have four cases. First case is we have a face data set. It contains 400 digital images and we randomly selected any digital image from this face data set, suppose this one, and here we entered the angle for rotation is 180 degree. You can see here face is detected. So this is the first case when face is detected. Second case, again we selected any random image from the face data set for testing, and when we apply this image on the proposed face detector, you can see here we have face in the image but it is not detected. So this is the second case. Third case is again we selected any random image from the face data set. When we tested it on the face detector, you can see it also detected something else that is not face. So this is false detection, third case. In fourth case, so this time we tested any digital image on the proposed face detector. Here we have no human face in the digital image. You can see no face, no detection. So this is the fourth case. So we have four cases. First case is face is detected. Second case, not detected. Third case, something else is detected as face. Fourth case, no face, no detection. Now we can understand face detector performance, that is its accuracy measurement through the confusion matrix. So this is the confusion matrix that we created for the proposed face detector. Here we have sub elements, face exist, not exist, face detected and face not detected. Here, case 1, face exist and it is detected. You can see the output here. In case 2, face exists in the distal image but it is not detected. You can see the output. Third case, face does not exist but it detected something else also as face. In fourth case, no face, no detection done. So now you can see here, first case is true positive, that is face exists and face is detected. Second case is false negative. It means face exists but it is not detected by the face detector. Third case, face does not exist but it detected something else also as face, that is not face. In fourth case, no face, no detection, that is true negative. Done. Now let's try to understand this again with an example. So we tested the proposed face detector on the ORL face dataset and it contained 400 digital images, and we tested the proposed face detector on 400 distal images and we found 366 distal images out of 400 correctly detected, 34 images not detected. If face exists and it is detected, that is true positive. Face exists, not detected, that is false negative. So we have a face data set contained 400 distal images, 366 distal images detected out of 400. That is true positive. So value for TP is 366. Second case, 34 digital images are not detected. So that is false negative and value for FN is 34. There is no false positive and no face, no detection. As in the face data set, we have all the face images. So value for this one is also 0. Now we will compute the face detector accuracy. Using this formula, we can compute the face detector accuracy. This is true positive, true negative, true positive, true negative, false positive and false negative. put the values here. Value for true positive is 366. You can see here. Value for true negative is 0. Value for true positive is 366. True negative is 0. False positive is 0. And false negative is 34. Put the values here and you can see we got 91.5% face detection accuracy for ORL face data set. After that, we again tested the proposed face detector on another face data set, that is LFW face data set, and we tested the proposed face detector on 139 digital images. You can see here, out of 139, 124 digital images are correctly detected. So the value for TP is 124. You can see the output here. We rotated digital images at different angle. You can see the faces detected, and these are the images that are not detected by the face detector. And for LFW, you can see the output here. Images are rotated and detected. That is 124 images are detected out of 139. So face exist and detected value is TP, and this is FN if it is not detected. If something else is detected, that is FP. So value for not detected images is 12, that is false negative. And we have also 3 images out of 139, that is false detection. And value for TN is 0, as in the face data set we have face images. Now we will compute the face detection accuracy for ORL face data set. Here you can see value for TP, that is true positive, is 124, TN is 0, TP is 124, TN is 0, false positive is 3. We got 3 images false detected. So value for FP is 3 and value for FN is 12, and we got 89.20% face detection accuracy for LFW face data set. After that, we will learn how we can compute the true positive ratio, false positive ratio, or true. So for true positive ratio, you can see here this formula, TP divided by TP plus FN. TP is true positive, this is false negative. Put the values and you can see we got 91.5%. For true negative ratio, TN divided by TN plus FP, put the values and we got 0%. False negative ratio is computed by this formula, put the values and we got 8.5% ratio. And false positive value is computed using this formula, put the value and we got 0%. After that, you can see for the ORL face data set, this is the confusion matrix. Here you can see true positive is 91.5%. Rate for true positive is 91.5%. Rate for false negative is 8.5. This one is 0. This one is also 0. And you can see when we computed this, we got 100. So this is the confusion matrix for ORL data set. So that's all about this video, how we can compute the true false positive values for any face data set. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.